dash a digi. The schedule busy, my head in a hoodie, my shorty a goodie, my cousins are crazy, my cousins like Boogie. Life is amazing, it is what it is.
Deep drop from Manning to left around Stabella.
NFL, how they supposed to pray to God if they keep waking up in hell? Been there so long, they got
me and Lil Baby, the shit going crazy. Weezy produced it and Weezy F made me, and she held it down, so she got a Mercedes. Your money records, the army, the name.
All right, so today's video, I want to show you guys what it's like being an NFL player. If you guys saw my video where I went to visit the Arizona Cardinals, you guys saw my homie Deion Buchanan, who plays for the Cardinals. He's been in the league for 5 years now and is a safety slash linebacker. If you guys didn't see the video of my visit, I stopped by Deion's condo and got a little tour of the NFL lifestyle. Now in today's video, we got to sit down and just catch up and talk about life. I really want my athletes to pay attention because I never got the chance to hear things like this, and I never knew what to expect at the next level or get an idea of what it's like playing in the NFL.
Good, bro.
Yeah.
He's gonna
give us a little tour.
You know?
Yeah.
So right here. Front room,
yeah.
Dining room kind of area, big screen, Fortnite, big pocket.
Ooh.
Right now. You know what I'm saying?
Okay.
Nothing too crazy.
Yeah.
Crazy.
Yeah.
Penthouse living, you feel me?
Yup.
But what we really like about the spot is this right here.
Oh, this is crazy.
Cool little balcony view.
Watch your step.
See all over Tempe.
Damn.
Downtown, a little set. Flashing lights, all that, man.
That's crazy.
Yeah, this is like one of those kind of things where you just think about, like, man, like, your whole life, you want to just change up a little bit, man. Like,
yeah,
And it's pretty painting, too, so I got to be paying for something, right?
Woo! For real.
How you been, bro?
Mostly just the same stuff. I'm trying to say, one day at a time, man. What about you, bro?
Same, bro. I mean, I'm grinding every day. The content that I put on YouTube is just my grind, so.
That's what I've been seeing, man.
Even at Wazoo, I was, like, trying to build my YouTube up.
Mm-hmm.
That's why I was doing my free time. Like, you never seen me out.
No, I really didn't.
Because I was trying to build that foundation for my YouTube.
Right.
I mean, the dream was always to make it to the NFL. How was that transition? Like going into the NFL, like what was the biggest difference from college to the NFL?
Shoot, biggest was probably like the playbook, you know what I'm saying? Like,
yeah.
I mean, you already know when you play in college, like they kind of like spoon feed you.
You
do with their parts and like they put in segments of how you're going, you know what I'm saying? This plays what we're going to do, and then you're going to learn these plays like piece by piece. Like the NFL is kind of just everything. They give you the playbook and like,
and it's more on you, huh? It's more on you.
You are yourself, you know what I'm saying? Like your grind is on your own. Like you don't have like Coach Loco, you don't have our strength
condition. Yeah, you don't have like mandatory anything.
Waking you up and things like that. Putting all that into account, you gotta put in your own work, get in what you put in, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, exactly.
You get out what you
exactly.
put in.
Exactly.
You know, but that's probably the biggest thing, but I mean, like I said, it's a drink of
truth. Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? So it's all that.
Damn, I still remember watching the draft, bro, and seeing you get picked. That was crazy.
Right, man, it was crazy for me, man. I mean, you know what I'm saying? My dogs over there, like, I wasn't, I don't know, I'm not gonna say I didn't expect it, you know what I'm saying? Cause, you know, I feel like I want, you know what I'm saying, I'm the best, especially coming out, you know, but my family, I was like, all right, you know, so it's here, kind of like chill, we're gonna have one party here, and then the next day, see what happens.
Uh-huh.
And then, next thing you know, late down the draft, and.
Yeah, you knew before you got picked, right?
Nah, I was just like, I mean, I didn't really know, but like, I went on a bunch of visits. Cardinals, I was like, by far, just like, the best, most at home.
Yeah. Was it kind of like high school, like recruiting, like colleges?
It was, kind of like that. Yeah. And just with less people, you know, college recruiters. There's a bunch of us, like, so usually like two or three players for each visit.
So you kind of knew who you were competing against.
Right, kind of.
And you knew you were better than them, so.
I mean, just, of course, that's the mindset you gotta have, but you know what I'm saying?
Of course,
like, in a respectful type way. It was cool, though. It was,
like
I said, now it's just staying in as long as you can. You know what I'm
What's the hardest part about being in the league?
That's a good question. I mean, It's a what have you done for me lately business, you know?
Yeah.
So, I mean, the slightest little dip in 1 year, you know, have just kind of like, know, there's always somebody out there trying to take your spot, you know? Yeah. You know what I'm saying? Because they have the same dreams as me, you know? There's a little 8-year-old out there right now, like, you know what I'm saying? This is what I want to do. You gotta keep going, I mean, but the hardest part, I don't know, like,
I mean, it's
football,
you know,
so it's easy for me to wake up and get to work.
I mean, you hear all the time how the league is kind of like a business, but mm-hmm. like, have you personally, like, experienced some of that stuff?
Yeah, I mean, not so much personally. I'm sure, like, it will come a time that I'll definitely, and that's going to happen for every player, you know? There's going to be a time, more times than not, it's the NFL kicking you out than you jumping out the NFL, you know? So, hope that time is no time soon, but just, you know what I'm saying, especially in training camp, you know what I'm saying, one day somebody be a certain number, and then the next day it'll be a whole different person, you know? But it's definitely business, though. Especially when it comes to contracts, things like that. You know what I'm saying? Numbers, as far as how many they got for the roster.
So you've been in the league for, five? This is your fifth year?
Yeah, my fifth year.
Right. So everything that you've gone through, and I mean, you've gone through to get where you're at, how much longer do you think you still want to play?
As long as possible, honestly.
For real?
Yeah, definitely. Definitely. Okay. I mean, it's nothing like easier. It's nothing like, I mean, not easier, but just for me personally, you know? Mm-hmm. Like, this is all I've known, you know what I'm saying? Yeah. You know what I'm saying? Seven. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? So it's just, it'd be just different. I mean, it's going to happen eventually because, I mean, eventually I'm about to go into that world and I'm about to, you know what I'm saying, figure something else out to do, but
make that transition.
Right.
That's where I was, bro, coming out of college. It was like the NFL didn't really work out how I wanted it to. I got a couple trials, but then it was like, damn, I gotta get a job.
Right.
And I never thought in my life I would have to get a job. That's never been in my future plans. Mm-hmm. That transition is hard, but like, what do you have any like plans for after? Are you even thinking about that right now?
Nah, I couldn't even tell you. Like, I mean, like you said, it's tough, but you know what I'm saying? You feel like you got this, you know what I'm saying? You worked hard for this. Mm-hmm. Like, it's hard to put my full energy into something else, you know what I'm saying? Because you're passionate about, you know what I'm saying? This, you know what I'm saying? This is what you're passionate about. You know? So it comes easy for you. So it's just like, how do I, it's hard to find something else that I'm passionate about. So it's just like, oh man, I enjoy doing that.
Yeah.
I enjoy, you know what I'm saying? Whatever that other thing is, like, putting all my energy into it, you know? So I never really had like another outlet. Throw something else in, like throw a little wrench in there or something like that, you know? But that's just something I gotta work on. Hopefully I find, you know, during this, you know, time I'm in the field, but go back to school and get my degree. Like,
You didn't finish?
Nah, I didn't finish. I left early, so I mean,
well, it'll be free, so.
Yeah, that's true.
Just off time.
It's just, I'm not trying to.
Yeah.
Back to pool. Back to cold, little pool, man. I don't know, I might have to do it. Like, I don't know, pool. I love pool, but.
Yeah.
I know, I spend enough time over in the Palouse, man. It's just a different world out there.
There's buildings out there now.
Right. Oh, for real, it's a lot of new buildings. It's a lot of new buildings. I mean, it's like, the culture's great out there. But the real, as far as. Real world, it's a whole world out there.
Yeah,
it's like,
it is.
You leave there and you're like, oh man, what's going on? You know what I'm saying? So,
one more question, bro. Going back to college football, that Auburn hit. Do you still think about that? Like, does that still, bro? Because every time I think about you, that's the first thing that pops up in my head is that hit.
Right.
Like, that was the hardest hit I've ever witnessed on TV, period. That was the hardest shit I've ever seen. I felt that.
Right.
What was your favorite play in college?
Dude, that was definitely my favorite play. I mean, people tell me about it more so than I probably think about it. You know what I mean? Because I don't know, like, I mean, most of the time I'm thinking of, you know what I'm saying? It's hard. I play a lot of plays, so it's just like, there's so many different plays. But, if I had to give a favorite, it's definitely that one. Yeah. I mean, like, it was a solid hit. I mean, like, it was perfect, bro. It was set up perfect, you know what I'm saying? So, I mean, and Auburn Stadium, like,
SEC
is big time. That was the first game. It set it off right there. Yeah.
You gotta play that, bro.
Run that back, Turbo.
I told Gunna it's your time to eat. These rappers corn balls, they telling lies on beats. Fuck his suit and tie, I got drip on me. Bitch, we got
is a clinic. This is a teaching year. Welcome. With all this, let me start.